Friends, I am covering with you hospital housekeeping management slide, which will give you detailed information about all the housekeeping operations. Housekeeping defined as the provision of safe, clean, and comfortable environment for patient attendant, hospital staff in a 24/7 setup. Responsibility of housekeeping department includes daily cleaning, periodic cleaning, trash and garbage removal, discharge cleaning, removal of bugs and pest prevention. Spread of infection, safety and security of the hospital, creating healing environment, interior decoration, crystallization also. Department objective includes maintain the aesthetic upkeep of the premises, achieve patient satisfaction to provide clean hygiene, stain-free linen and uniform for our patient and employee in the hospital. I have designed this slide in such a way that you will go through the slide. The slide is itself enough to brief you about the housekeeping operation. Overview on housekeeping department, modern perspective, physiological impact of patient, improved hygienic practices and better sanitary condition have a direct relation to the post-operative complication under direction of a housekeeping department. Members of housekeeping are expert in cleaning and organizing in housekeeping activities because their schedule and permanent training keeps going on. Principle of management of housekeeping department, that is plan, organize, coordinate, control and monitor all the housekeeping activities. Housekeeping skills includes many other things. Housekeeping is an art which cannot be performed by everyone. You know, facade and glass cleaning is also comes under this. Gardening also comes under this. Scope of housekeeping includes facade cleaning, pest controlling, horticulture gardening, laundry service and uniform room, biomedical waste collection, storage, general waste removal, HK and GD staff handling. Apart from this, in transport desk control, which is internal, that is the transportation of patient on time inside the hospital from one unit to other examination units. Housekeeping focus very much on the mechanical cleaning and mechanized cleaning reduces the efforts of housekeeping staff because machine can work more than human efforts. Here in the picture you can see how managed housekeeping department is and how they carry out their activities. This slide is itself self-explanatory about the housekeeping operations. Now about the housekeeping hierarchy, the department is headed by manager housekeeping, which reports to facility director, and he is assisted by assistant manager, supervisors, contractual supervisor, glass and facade cleaning, horticulture gardener, housekeeping GDA supervisor, pest control, laundry and linen management can have a laundry manager, laundry supervisor, and in laundry, the laundry attendants, valet, they report to the laundry manager, and in housekeeping and GDA support staff, GDA housekeeping cleaner, they report to the housekeeping supervisors. Aims of housekeeping department includes achieve the maximum efficiency possible in the care and comfort of the patient in the smooth running of hospital, establish a welcome atmosphere and a courteous, reliable service for staff of all department, ensure a high standard of cleanliness and general upkeep in all area, train, control and supervise the staff of housekeeping department, establish a good working relation with other department, ensure that safety and security regulations are made known to the hospital staff. Common pests in the hospitals can be bugs, rats, cockroaches. Pest prevention from pest control. Daily fogging also happens in the hospital during rainy season. The dawn fogging also happens. Now come to the supervisor responsibility. Supervisor responsibility includes briefing of team and follow up instruction of manager executive laundry and consumable asset receivable and challan documentation inventory keeping round of the area before the operational round doctor visit meet patient and take feedback to improve services maintain reporting and check machines and equipment checklist following up conducting training. From this, the supervisor also needs to maintain the checklist of the washrooms, floors and public areas. Supervisor plays a multitasking role on the floors and public area. Now interdepartmental coordination. Housekeeping is needs to do a better coordination with maintenance, nursing, front office, security, store, receiving and other departments. Nursing, he coordinates for the patient movements, and patient assistant front office, he coordinates for handing over them the rooms. Maintenance, they coordinate for the any maintenance issues like carpentry, plumbing or other issues in the rooms. For security, they coordinates for safety and the security related concern. Suppose some fight has happened or some court violence has happened, so they coordinate for it. Store and receiving, they coordinate for indent and material procurement related to their department. Other departments like IT, they coordinate for some PMS related issues or indent related issue in software. Finance, they coordinate for handing over the bills on time. Common housekeeping practices in key working area, systematic cleaning operations, basic work procedure, control of odor, pest, rodent and animal control, waste disposal methods and procedures, safety regulation, accident, fire, electrical, care of furniture, interior decoration, storage procedure for used equipment. New development in housekeeping concept. With the time, some new changes keeps on coming. Eco-friendly hygienic solution by practice, seeing they reduce three, that is reduce, reuse and recycle, that is hand dryer, toilet roll, dispenser, etc. Customer friendly service by regular training of staff, customer education on daytime cleaning. Daytime cleaning can help to address issue of corporate social responsibility like saving energy. Daytime cleaning is taking more responsible stances to social trends. Daytime cleaning raises productivity level, which reduces cost. Department functional, giving cleaning service to patient room, wards, ICU, OPD, OT as per SOP, that is standard operating procedure, replenish the amenities in the patient room, water service in patient room, wards, OPD, collection, transport of waste, patient transportation on wheelchair and stretcher, issuing linen and uniform to different sections. Challenges, routines need to be planned so that they do not inconvenience doctor, nurses, visitor. Cleaning has to be consistent, suitable in conjunction with nursing procedure, that is making before vacuum cleaning. Bed making before vacuum cleaning, a greater need for flexibility and ability to adjust to interruption. Shortage of staff, high turnover, manpower training, washroom cleaning. Washroom cleaning is very important as it leads to infection control. In hospital, we cater patients, so it become more important to clean the washroom and maintain hygienic condition of washroom. Apart from the washroom, should be dry and clean always so that the patient fall cannot happen. The lift button switches, door knobs transfer microbial, thus after more infection than seats, so it can be sanitized properly. Teamwork, timely service, Laundry. Now come to the laundry. Laundry operation is also very important. First is the collection, then sorting out the linen, washing, drying, finishing, folding, delivering. These are the huge machines, washer and dryers used in laundry. Layout of the laundry, you can see in the layout. There you can find the washer machine, you can find the calendaring machine, you can find the pressing machine, and the complete laundry layout, the transportation trolleys. Waste segregation is also an important part in housekeeping. There are basically 5 types of dustbin used in the hospitals. Black is for general waste. In some places, green also used for general waste. Yellow is for contaminated body parts. We dispose of in yellow, that is cotton, infected cotton, gauze, linen, condom, linen, body fluid. Red contains infected plastics. Blue cardboard box is there for unbroken glasses, used injection vials. Puncture proof white sharp container are there. I will show you the photographs of those in the earlier in the next slide. All sharp plates, broken glasses are put in puncture proof white sharp containers. See, you can see the blue boxes, you can see the white sharp containers, white dustbin, or red dustbin, yellow dustbin. Disposable process: do not recap the needle. You need to prevent yourself from NSI, needle stick injury, and it should be, the dustbin should be cleaned when 75% about to fill, so in order to prevent others for getting in contact with it or get the NSI. Even the transporter can get the NSI, or the disposer can get the NSI if the dustbin overflows. The container should not leak because it will spread the infection. And daily pickup of biomedical waste is also very important. There is certain government guidelines of CPCB and State Pollution Control Board that needs to be followed. The soul of housekeeping is good housekeeping, means good safety. If your housekeeping is good, your housekeeping personnels are alert, then you will find a safe environment for you. Conclusion: the housekeeping department is a non-revenue producing service department in the hospital, a purely run department. Results in money needlessly spent and create a negative impression of patient, visitor, and staff, which will adversely affect their perspective and perception of the quality of care provided by the hospital. So, a good housekeeping is very much important for any hotel. Thank you very much. I hope you will like my video and will share it to your friends also. Thank you.